currently logged in as you. I thought I'd make a short little video just to show you what I had tried to explain in text earlier. So as you can see over here, I've snuck in as you, and I'm going to go over here to Miss Magnante's class. And since I sent you that email, I have gone in and actually changed it so that if you click on the Unit 1 assignment list, these, they don't link anymore. So you see I can't link out, and that's because it was sending me to a false link. You can still use this assignment list page, though, to mark off everything that you've done, to use it as a checklist. So if you notice, it says here that all of these three assignments are located on the Concept 1.1 Instructional Materials page. So I'm going to come over here, and I see Concept 1.1, and I open it, and this is where my instructional materials are. Concept 1.1 Instructional Materials, Concept 1.1 Instructional Materials. So you can see how this side over here on the checklist matches up with your unit over here. So I'm going to go to that page. And I know we're looking for the Beowulf Word Cloud project. So here I learn about Beowulf and Anglo-Saxons. Then I do my reading of Beowulf, take notes. I can see episode 3 here. I've got my study guide that I can download. I've got a conversation that I need to participate in. And so if you'll notice, the directions for the Word Cloud activity are actually right here. Take a look at the word cloud to the left. As you see, this is created out of keywords from the text. You now need to create a word cloud such as this. And then there's directions. It tells you how to get to that, to those directions for that assignment. But I've done my word cloud, right? And I'm ready to turn it in. Well, here's my Dropbox. And it tells me explicitly on the page, turn in your Beowulf word clouds here. So let's say that I've finished my episode 4 word cloud and ready to turn it in. Well, I go right over here to where it tells me to hand it in. I click hand in, and then I just fill out this form. So most likely you're going to need to attach a file from your computer. You'll choose the file in the same way that you would choose any file. I'll just choose this boring piece of work here. And you see that your file attaches right here, and then you just click hand in, which I'm not going to do because then your teacher will be very confused about why she had this PDF. But that's how it works, right? So you go to the actual page that the assignment is on, and you find where it tells you to turn it in, you click hand in, and then you attach your work there. And that is truly the best way to get to the work in the course. I hope this has proved helpful. If you still have questions, just shoot me another email. Thanks.